It's not about me, as if you should do things my way. You alone are God, and I surrender. It's all about you. It's not about me, as if you should do things my way. You alone are God, and I surrender to your ways.
Let us come to God in prayer. Heavenly Father, Almighty God, we give you thanks and praise for this wonderful opportunity during this time of Reformation remembrance to praise you, to listen to your word as you direct our paths and as you remind us of the focus that we must have on Scripture and faith alone in you and what your word tells us, on the grace that we receive from you in Christ Jesus and his actions. Today, O God, as we think of Christ alone, we ask that you pour out your spirit upon us as we seek your blessings. Open our hearts, our minds, our spirits, O God, as we offer this prayer in and through the word made flesh, O Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.
Today's first scripture reading is taken from the Gospel of John, chapter 1, reading verses 1 to 6. Before the world was created, the Word already existed. He was with God, and he was the same as God. From the very beginning, the Word was with God. Through him, God made all things. Not one thing in all creation was made without him. The Word was the source of life, and this brought light to mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has never put it out. God sent his messenger, a man named John. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God for his word. Amen. Today's second scripture reading is taken from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, reading verses 1 to 9. Do not be worried and upset, Jesus told them. Believe in God and believe also in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house, and I am going to prepare a place for you. I would not tell you this if it were not so. And after I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you there myself, so that you will be where I am. You know the way that leads to me, the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way to get there? Jesus answered him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one goes to the Father except by me. Now that you have known me, he said to them, you will know my Father also. And from now on, you do know him, and you would have seen him. Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father. That is all we need. Jesus answered, for a long time I have been with you all, yet you do not know me, Philip. Who has ever seen me has seen the Father. Why then do you say, show us the Father? This is the word of God. Thanks be to God for his word. Amen.
As we continue in this Reformation Month series, as we look at the pillars of our faith, today we are focusing on Christ alone. Christ is the central figure of our Christian faith and belief. He is what defines us, our belief, our trust, and our faith in him. The passages that were read for us from John chapter 14, Jesus proclaims to his disciples, I am the way, the truth, and the life. It is one of the seven I am sayings. And these I am sayings, as they have been studied and analyzed, we see that when Jesus proclaims and says, I am, that he is equating himself to God. We believe that Jesus is God. And in this definitive statement of who he is, I am the way. I am the truth. I am the life. We see Jesus here not offering any alternative, but saying, stating, proclaiming that he is. I am. John chapter 1, those verses that follow, John introduces and initiates that definition of Jesus in the first few lines of his book and of this chapter. We see John presenting Jesus as the Word, who was there from the beginning, who in and through all things were created and made. So we see here then that just as Jesus proclaimed, I am the way, the truth, and the life, John also says it and states it in these verses. Jesus is the source of all life. Verse 4, he tells this to us. He is the source of life who, through all things and all creation, was made. And we think of Jesus, his actions, the sacrificial love shown on the cross, the atonement for our sins, winning for us eternal life. So as creator, he has also won for his creation salvation. And we are told and given to us that blessed and familiar formula from John 3:16, that because of the love of God for the world, that Jesus came so that because of our belief in him, we will have what? Eternal life. Jesus is the source of life. Then, John chapter 1, verse 14, a little later down in our reading, in our passage this morning, we are told by John that Jesus was full of truth. What is the truth of our lives? The well-known and popular evangelist, Billy Graham, once stated in a sermon that everyone is searching for the truth in all different places and in all different areas and facets of life. But for us, the truth has been given to us in Christ Jesus, who says that he is the truth. The truth of our lives in Christ Jesus is that we have from God life. We have from God salvation. We have from God an unconditional love. And we have now been redefined by it. There is no other truth that we can stand on, that we can trust in, that we can rely on. The truth of our lives is that our sins have been atoned by Jesus on the cross. The truth of our lives is that we are now sons and daughters, made so in and through the sacrifice of our Lord. We are defined by his truth. And the word that he speaks and brings and gives to us is a truth that is solid, that is sure, and that is the foundation of our lives. Who Jesus says he is, who others says he is, who God the Father says he is our truth as Christians. So as we think of the life that Jesus has given to us, the created life and the life eternal and everlasting that goes beyond this life and this side of eternity, as we hold on and rely on the truth to guide us, the truth that we are the children of God, we now receive from this life and this love, we think of the path. Jesus says to his disciples, I am the way. And he says something that may seem exclusive, where he says, no one comes to the Father but by me. When we think of Christ alone, we can think of this statement because we know that Jesus himself says that he is the only source, the means, and the way by which we go to the Father. But this is not exclusive. It is inclusive because he is for all. This one way, this the way that he presents and gives to us and that he is the way that is available to us all. To embrace that way, to embrace that truth, to embrace that life. He is the way to the Father because He alone, by His sacrifice, by His life, won for us through His death. We have that life eternal, and we then embrace Him as the way to go to the place that He has prepared for us, for you and for me. He makes and takes us to the Father. My father, always when he taught his classes and when he spoke to Reverend Adrian and myself and gave us advice on how to preach, would tell us that in sermon preparation, always begin with Christ, preach Christ, and end with Christ. He is the Alpha and the Omega. The book of Revelation presents that image of Christ who sits on the throne, who reigns and rules, and who is one with the Father. This is the Jesus who alone can save us. This is the Jesus who alone, through his actions, has won for us life eternal and everlasting. Let us put our faith and our trust in him as we listen to his word and his word alone, as we have that faith and that faith alone in him, as we receive that grace that comes from him alone, and as we worship and praise God the Father. In the name of the Son, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Holy Spirit, we offer these words. Bow with me in prayer. Almighty God, in and through Christ Jesus, you have shown us the way, the truth, and the life. Help us, O God, as your people, to follow him along the way and the path of this life that leads to a righteous walk, that leads to life eternal and everlasting, so that when we depart this life, we can go to the promised place prepared for us. Help us, Heavenly Father, to embrace and to acknowledge the truth that he tells us, the truth that he has demonstrated and shown, given to us, so that our lives can stand on this sure foundation, this solid truth of who you are and who we are in Christ Jesus. And Heavenly Father, Almighty God, we thank you for the life that he has won for us through his sacrifice, through your love shown through him. Let us live this life in abundance. Let us live this life and continue to share your love and your light. Receive this prayer as we offer this in the blessed name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Hear us, O God, as we join together as a community and as a people of faith, and say the words that he himself has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And as we close our service, we unite in that final prayer and benediction. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for these series of services, and we ask for your ever-present power and strength over this pastoral region, over this church. We ask, Heavenly Father, that you continue to guard and guide us in all that we do, and let us reflect your glory as we offer this and seek the blessing of the one God whom we worship, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And we pray that this one God rests, remains, and abides with each and every one of us and all his people here and everywhere, now and always.